الحمد لله رب العالمين، الصلاة والسلام على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد وبارك وسلم. Praise be to Allah, all grace and mercy and from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who has allowed us and permitted us the chance to witness the blessed first 10 days of the month of Dhul-Hijjah, days in which the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam taught us that there are no days in which deeds are more beloved to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala than these 10 days of the first of Dhul-Hijjah. This is a time of reward. It's a time in which Allah knows the ibad, knows who's capable of staying up at night in the month of Ramadan, and knows who can better, is more capable of earning reward in the daytime during the month of Dhul-Hijjah. This is a chance for us as believers to get ahead. You don't have to wait until next Ramadan and look for Laylatul Qadr. If we've already made it, alhamdulillah. Now add on to your scale of good deeds with doing as much worship as possible in these first 10 days of the month of Dhul-Hijjah. So with that, we've put together this mini series. Every day we're going to be dropping a video in the first 10 days of the month of Dhul-Hijjah as a quick reminder on what we should do as believers. The first reminder that I'll offer today is to fast as much as possible in these 10 days. Fasting is one of the most rewarded deeds in Islam, as how the Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has taught us that as-sawmu li, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that fasting is for Allah and Allah alone will reward fasting. Every other deed you could possibly show off in. Every other deed you could pray so that people say, oh wow, this person prays. You can read Quran so that people will say, oh wow, this person has such a beautiful voice and reads and memorizes so much Quran. You can give sadaqah and people may notice it and say, wow, this person is so generous. However, fasting is such a personal and humble connective relationship with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that no one would ever know if you're fasting or not, because this is a personal connection with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So in these 10 days, it is highly recommended that we fast as much as possible from the first 9 days of the month of Dhul-Hijjah. And if we cannot fast all of them or some of them, then at least to fast the 9th of Dhul-Hijjah, as Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam taught us that fasting on the 9th of Dhul-Hijjah, or what is known as the day of Arafah for those who are going for Hajj, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala take us there sometime soon. On that day, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has said that fasting that day, for those who are not at Hajj, meaning for us, will be an expiation, meaning an excuse of sins for 2 whole years, a year prior and a year forward. So with that, we pray that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives us the ability to fast in these blessed 10 days, in the first 9 days. We ask that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept our ibadah, that we are charitable and we are conscious of our family members and we are giving and we are nice to one another, and that even in whatever difficult times we may find in, we find the opportunity to thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for what we have. Be thankful to Allah, the most gracious, the most merciful, the beneficent, the one who gives us everything, and to the one whom we shall return one day. We pray that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala send abundant peace and blessings and salutations upon our beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Wa akhru da'wana and alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen.